Here in California, viticulture, the growing of grapes and the making of wine, is a multi-billion dollar industry.
So growers want to know how climate change and a drier and hotter environment will affect their vines. The Academy's Dylan Burge is on the job.
We're interested in the California native grape because if you want to grow a wine grape in California, very often they incorporate the genetics of the native California grape into the rootstock that these plants are grafted onto, because the native California grapes are already resistant to a lot of the pathogens that are in the soils in California.
Dylan studies the phenology of grapes.
Phenology is basically the timing of the major events in a plant's life cycle. So for instance, a plant that goes dormant during the winter, when the weather begins to warm, its buds open and the leaves emerge. That's a phenological event. Sometimes a few weeks or a month or two later, the plants will bloom. The blooming is a phenological event. And the final phenological event in a plant that's deciduous would be for the leaves to fall off and for the fruits to ripen. It's important to understand the timing of phenological events because the amount of variation for these traits that's present in a species determines their ability to respond to changes in the climate.
And even though the project has just started, Dylan and his colleagues plan to help the wine industry succeed in a warming landscape.
Having complete information on the 1,300 or so different types of wine varieties that are out there, in addition to these 10 or 12 that we really love, will allow us to predict the places where these varieties will do best. If we know exactly which varieties have the best tolerance for heat or the least tolerance for heat, we might be able to pick and choose varieties that will be well suited to particular areas of wine country and other places around the world under future climate change.